Hello everyone and welcome back to the World Super League Career Mode. In this episode we are going to be taking on Basel away, followed by Hamburg at home, then Sassuolo at home again. So a couple of home ties should treat us nicely. I think we had two home ties out of three last episode as well, so I feel like we're due a number of away ties in a row soon. So this one to start with. On the road, we've actually been better generally throughout the series. But generally all round, recently our form's been pretty damn good. We won 2 and drew 1 last episode to increase our lead. I think we've kept pace with Fenerbahce, to be fair, but we've increased the lead on certain teams. And, you know, long may that continue. We really are in form. Also, a few players emerged last episode that we just absolutely beat. This guy, for instance, Robinson, slightly fatigued, but I'm going to have him on the bench for Hernandez, who's not going to feature because it'll tire him. And we'll get Dietrich on the bench as well because he's got high prospects for Van Drongelen. In fact, you know what? I'll start Van Drongelen. He's not played so much. I think he's only played twice, and Ayan's played a fair whack. So I'll take him out the setup entirely. But Robinson played CDM instead of Fosu and played a 7-6 on his debut. So really excellent from him. Iheanacho, last time both he and Berahino were fit, I opted for Iheanacho because he got a brace, but it's got to be Saido time for me. We'll start Peñaranda soon though. He's not started a game all season aside from the cup. And despite going up a rating this season, he has been our weakest centre forward, but I do feel like he's not really been given a fully fair chance of things, to be honest, to make a name for himself. I was nowhere near ready for this training drill, so we'll just sack this off for sure. We had it though, by Rash, bit of practice. So here we go against Basel. Can't see where they are right there in the league, but there's our situation, as we have the best goal difference in the league by a distance and the most points, least defeats. We really have started the season nicely. Disappointing draw last time out, considering it was a last minute equaliser by Mainz. But performance wise, we played pretty well. So we look to maintain that. Van Drongelen feeds in George. He's found Ricky. Ricky, lovely ball to Rash. Oh, straight away, boys. Straight to fucking way. 2 minutes in. First attack. Basel have not touched the ball. And Ricky gets himself an assist with a brilliantly timed ball to Rashford, who just cannot stop scoring. Marcus has got 4 last episode, I think, in 3 games. And he also got the header against Mainz that pretty much gave Tielemans a tap in. So excellent work by him. Sapanaro's dealt with this so well. And he's unleashed Saido. Saido! Oh, it's 2 already, boys! Excellent finish by Saido. He brings out my favourite celebration, the homer. Get in, Saido. And 2 assists for Sapanaro, who just dispossesses the man. Waits and waits, feeds a lovely ball through. Good first touch, takes him away from goal. And just bangs it straight across the keeper with his powerful left foot. This has got to be the best start I've ever made on this career mode in any match. You know, I don't think I've ever scored 2 so early. El Younesi. I do tend to score really early in games in the first episode of the day, actually. The first game of the episode, sorry. I do often score early in that, but I didn't really expect this. 2-0. It's Xhaka. That's a Granit Xhaka's brother, that one. Great tackle by Yuri Tielemans. He just does a front flip over the car, though. So, yeah, Boetius giving it to Riveros. And I don't think there's been a game in the league so far this season where we've conceded more than 1, so that really bodes well already. However, danger there. They could have made something more from that. But it's across the mark. He's surely fouled. Asserting his authority here early on, giving that free kick. Klostermann's just look for that early. Good pressure, this. Lucky boys. Traveros. El Younesi. Challenge by Rash. Just keep them pinned back. Well done, Rash. Excellent anticipation. Oh, George. Lovely play by George. Saido. Oh, it's saved by Salvi. We are playing dynamite football right now, boys. Win that. It's out by Xhaka. But that's got to be considered our best performance of the season so far. Just hopefully that carries. Tielemans giving it away here. Lionessi. Xhaka. Riveros. Well done, Lucas. And the result is going to be a throw. Oh, Lucas Klosterman. Almost. That would have been sick if they found Rashford. As he just came steaming in. Got himself a diving header on it. It's Bertius. Great run by the lad. He's given too much there though, and Ake will deal with this pretty comfortably. George. And to Ricky. I didn't think Saponara started as well as a new Tielemans could do in camp, but today he's been our best player so far, for sure. George. Oh, good ball to Tielemans, and it was excellent hold up play by Yori. He looks inside. Saido just ran into the back of this guy though, and that curtailed his momentum. Well won the header by Ake though. I'm going to bang it with Saponara. Almost came back to Saido. We still got it. Ricky! I don't really know who that deflected off. It was Barahino. So it should really be more than two already. Oh, perhaps that's over exaggerated. It could be more than two. May yet. The Saido wins it. Oh. I've got to be honest, I thought I'd fouled him, but came away with it, ball in, and really, Salvi punching it away, he could have gone anywhere. He got lucky that it went straight to his man. Basel are just being so ponderous on the ball, and we're just pressing them so easily into these mistakes as we continue to press them high up the pitch. They've run it back this time, though, as they go running down with Bertius, who has looked their best player this game. Oh, Lionessi can't get behind Van Drongelen. Ake. Christensen. Klosterman gives it away, but stalled by Deer. Oh, shit. Klosterman put Ake in the stick there, and they've got it here with Xhaka. Stefan. Danger, boys, danger. He's got inside. Oh, the outside of the post from Stefan. So we've kept four clean sheets in five at the least. I'd like to continue that record, but really dangerous start from Basel. It's the first time they've really gotten behind and sort of skipped past me. Great challenge by Andreas again to deny Lionessi. Throw in here by Riveros, but. Hello, Christensen. Can't keep it in now. They continue to press us here. It's a good ball in as well. Get rid of Ake. Oh, it's easily dealt with though by Costil. Oh, we could be in. As Ricky picks it up. Now he's fed. Rash. It was great play by Ricky. Rashford. Oh, it's over. Get in, boys. 3-0 up. Marcus Rashford gets a brace for the third time in four games, I think. And wow. This is a bit of a brushing aside of Basel, to be honest. Both strikers cause mayhem here. And again, it's a third assist, I think, for Saponara, who's surely won the match, despite Rashford's brace. Stefan is the one who dribbled past me last time, though. And here he goes again. Oh, they're in all sorts of room. Xhaka, that was too easy. Really, they should have scored that. But on the whole, I'm delighted that the half, of course. Fenerbahce are losing away to Olympiacos as well, so that's a bonus as well, as they currently lie just 2 points behind us. I think Olympiacos are in third. So a big bonus that they're playing each other. We've already played both and took 4 points off them, so. Our fixtures, of course, are lacking in games against them as well, so. They will struggle to catch up with us with a lack of direct opportunity too until after Christmas at the least. So come on, lads, win here today. We'll be 4 points clear, I think. Or maybe even five. Xhaka. It's rare that I'd beat teams by more than one or two last season as well, and we've had plenty more 3-0 wins this time. This is going to be the fourth 3-0 win in... Hang on, what score did we win the last game? Yeah, it's going to be the fourth 3-0 win in six games, I think, if we hold this in the league, which is a pretty good going because, of course, our goal difference is really on the up. And Tep, nice. Okay, just cuts inside, easy does it. Still Nathan. There's the ball to Rash. He's looked to go back inside. Excellent from Rash. Oh, cleared in the hand by Sushi. Well, that's proper defending. They can't score from there. It's out of play. George with the throw. Gets to side though. Looked to go inside to Ake, to be honest, but I didn't want to play it to Timothy. Riveros. Klosterman's going to try and track back. He just stopped though. What are you doing, Klosterman? Bertius. Landjongelin tries to clear it and just hit it straight to Christensen. This has been disastrous defensively, that attack. But we have come away. We're in a decent situation now. Yuri's found a great ball through to Rash. He looks back for Yuri. Yuri has no pace. It's the only thing he lacks. DA. Bertius. Terrible by Bertius. I read that by Ake. Cuts across. Klosterman to Yuri. Oh, lovely turn by Saponara. What a game he's having. He gives it to George. He's going to wait and wait and play it. I was looking for Ake, but Saido will have. And I think it's going to be sub time now. So, as ever, Tielemans tires so much, so he never seems to finish 90 minutes. So, bring Dietrich on. Give him a game. Lewis Cook for Fosu. And Peñaranda for Saido. Will that Rashford have the chance to get his hat-trick. Okay. Here is Peñaranda. He whips it in. Decent ball. Ricky wins the header. Get in, boys. He deserves that. His play. So Peñaranda gets the assist after his second touch, I think it was. First touch, easy to control. He has another one. Third touch in. Ball. And I was looking for the header for Rashford originally, but Saponara rises like a salmon. 4-0. Wow. It's our biggest win of the season, this. I had a chance to dispossess Balanta there. Ede Balanta's a really good player, by the way. It's good signing by Basel. And John Gillen. Attack was looking good. Now the opposition have a chance. Oh, Andreas, he's giving it away. Let's keep the clean sheet, lads. Stefan, oh, well done, Costa. Plays out to George. To Ricky. He was caught, but Cook comes away. Nice play by Cook. Now it's Costa on. Into Dietrich. Oh, lovely from Dietrich. Tackled down by Riveros. Costa on. The throw. To Rash. Dietrich's won it. Dietrich, ball in. Peñaranda, oh, get it, boys. This is working out ideal. The subs. Assist for Dietrich, the Youth Academy product. The first he's had. First goal for Peñaranda for the club, I'm pretty sure. For powerful header off the underside of the bar. Peñaranda's been on for, what? 8 minutes. He's got a goal and assist. And they're two players that I really felt needed to do something to. I say that, Saponara as well, going into this game. Players who, despite saying on the squad team lineup that they're in form, in terms of goals and assists, they haven't really done much. Well, they've all come to the party today. 5-0, wow. It could get worse. Klosterman's running on, and he has tons of pace. He looks inside to Rash. He's just over under. Still searching for that elusive first hat-trick for the club, Rash, but he's another one today. He's had a really, really solid game. Dietrich, tied to Klostermar. Lucas gives it to Peñaranda. Trying it straight into Balanta. George, well played by you, George. He's really settled. Coming to his own recently, George. Now he feeds the ball. Great timing to Rashford. Oh, he gets his hat-trick. It's 6. Counts him 6-0 away to Basel. Oh, my word. And world-class as well. I mean, I know some YouTubers playing Legendary, to be fair, but quite a few playing pro as well. We're on world-class here with Bournemouth. I'm winning 6-0 against Basel away. I'm impressed with the team, I'll be honest. I really am arse looking at them right now, but we had our tough periods, you know. We had times in League 2 where we were doing 1 out of 5, so I'm really, really enjoying this form. There may well be a time in the season where we do go 5 without a win. So right now, while we're in form, I'm enjoying every minute of this. This is brilliant. Giving it away now, though. Saved by Costa. We do seem to have turned a corner, though, this season. Last season, we did get promoted, but it was by fingertips, to be honest. We got promoted by a point. Now this one, I feel like we could potentially run away with the league if we keep playing like this. Look at Rashford go. Marcus, Peñaranda, it's 7. Oh my God, easily our biggest win. I'm going to run to the hoarding boards and try and celebrate there, which Peñaranda does. He stands on there. Peñaranda, wow. Maybe I should consider him more. Certain previous times, he's not really done too much, but he's been on for 26 minutes, got a goal and 2 assists. Rashford runs through, it's it. To be fair, it was unlucky for them. It came straight off the man, Balanta. Straight to Peñaranda. He side foot to in. In second half, we have blown Basel away. Oh, they got Jermaine Defoe. Jermaine, why is he not starting? He's fucking unreal, Jermaine Defoe. I love the play. Cook. Could they get worse, boys? Ricky holds it up. Looks for Dietrich. Don't really know what I was trying there, but Dietrich. Oh, we almost forced a mistake, though. Win that, Christopher. Oh, well, boys. Best performance of the whole series so far, it's got to be said. Marcus Rashford gets the hat-trick. I'm not sure, but I think it's the first hat-trick of the series for us. The only slight doubt is that Iheanacho might well have got one at some point, but certainly Marcus got his this time. And there's going to be a lot of players who played potentially 10s here. We had 11 shots, they're 6, 10 on target, so they're 3. Tied possession, actually, they had 92% pass accuracy, we had 85. It did not show, really, in the actual game. Too many times we made crucial tackles on them in situations, and Basel were really poor, to be honest. I was right, well, we have 3 players who got 10s. Ricky Saponara, Marcus Rash, and Adalbert Peñaranda. So 3 goals for Rashford, 2 for Peñaranda, 1 for Saponara, and 1 for Saido. Assists, 3 for Saponara, 1 for Peñaranda, 1 for George, 1 for Dietrich. And yeah, that's it in terms of assists. Just all around, well, we really did completely dominate that game. And, what's her name? Our goal difference has taken a big, big boost there. Fenerbahce ended up drawing with Olympiacos. That's actually probably better for us, if anything, to be fair. Galatasaray drew at West Brom as well. That's a help. As you can see, we're 4 points clear now of Fener and 5 clear of Olympiacos. So, yeah, as I said, I think that's a bit better. We would have been 4 clear of Olympiacos and 5 clear of Fenerbahce had the result been different. In fact, we would have been 3 clear of Olympiacos. So, yeah, I don't mind that at all. We've now scored the most in the league as well by a fair bit, 3 goals above Mainz. We've also conceded at least. Galatasaray have only conceded 9 to their credit, but we've conceded 7 in 14 games, which is decent. And long may this continue, boys. Certainly looking good for at the least a playoff place, as we currently lead St Etienne by 8 points. And despite the league being ridiculously close, you know, it seems the bottom must be doing so shit. It's Bordeaux, just killing everyone. I actually only beat Bordeaux 2-1 though, to be fair. So, Most of the games they're losing are by the odd goal. But yeah, I think we've really pulled away of the sides that are like tight. You can see from Fenerbahce down to Nice, second to 18th, is just 10 points. But we, in terms of our goal difference and our points, look like we could pull clear of a pack that, you know, the point I'm making is that second down to 18th, they're all taking points off each other. As long as we keep winning, keep this form going, we're laughing. Because most of the points we dropped were early on the season. I'll show you the calendar as we head up to our next game and work out what our current form actually is. But it's time to take Boris off the training, fortunately. And we will give it to this Julian Milo, who really did like the look of. We'll give him one on the 1-2 defending. We'll take Dietrich off. Really high prospect, Dietrich, but he is getting a lot of game time now, so he'll probably naturally go up anyway. And we'll give one to Galliano, he did like the look of, but I think it was Robinson. I was considering, he is 17 to be fair. I thought he was younger than that, but this guy was a beast last time we played him in CDM. And he will probably end up being the replacement for Fosu Mensah whenever Fosu's tired in CDM. So we'll get him on a defending training drill for sure. We'll keep Bustos on one. He's been flying up, generally. You know, we'll get a scene, he'll just go up and rating like a boss. So we'll keep him. And Cruz is a skull future star, so we'll maintain him on the two as well. So something like that. Let's see how we do. Not great, to be honest. DFD, DC is pretty damn poor. So we'll keep these guys on for another week at least. Lewis Cook's thanking us. Don't know why. Because he wanted a wage increase and we just ignored him. So must be on football grounds. Yeah, he must have asked for more game time. I actually have only given him two appearances in the last five or six games. So it didn't seem much more than I was giving him, to be honest. But clearly he's happy for some reason. But yeah, in terms of form, going back, we lost to Newcastle. This is our form all round, actually. We drew our first game, so we dropped points there. We won the next three, to our credit, and lost them two cup games. That one against Panathinaikos was the same, actually, so that took us out of that competition. We beat Lokomotiv, then lost to Seville in the second round of the EFL Cup, so that was disappointing. I think if we were to play Seville now in the form that we're in, we'd beat them quite comfortably, actually. I mean, as it is, that 1-0 defeat was harsh. Yeah, we did lose to Newcastle, beat Olympiakos, then drew the next two against Hertha Berlin and CSKA. So that's what I mean. We've currently dropped, how many points are we on? I think we're on 31 from 14 games, so 11 points we've dropped. 9 of them were in them matches. Since then, we've beaten Depor 3-0, beaten Stoke 3-0. Beat West Brom 3-0, beat Bordeaux 2-1. Drew with Mainz 1-0, but it was the last minute goal conceded. Then beat Basel 7-0. So our form is decent. We've won 5 out of 6 and drew the other. We are the form team in the league heading into the game against Hamburg, the last of the month. So I can go full pelt with this, even if people are tired, because they have a 2-week break. Hamburg are currently just outside the playoffs, I think. As you can see, they're ninth, the 9 points behind us. They must have lost the last couple, because they were as high as fourth, I think, recently. So, big win. We'll probably put them out of permanent reach of us in terms of the table, to be honest. Unless we really do go on a horrendous run. But hopefully that isn't the case. First team is ready as well. Based on how they played last game, I could argue for Peñaranda and Berahino both to come in. I'm going to give Adelbert a chance. Really was solid from the bench. So, I mean, he might be more of an impact striker. I think this game might showcase that. It'll answer that question once and for all, you know. But I'm a manager on FIFA career mode who tends to play players on form. I'm so bad at pence. It's just a variation then, you know. You just fire one up, then the next one's too weak.
It's going to be very tough for the opposition today to break down the home team's defence.
So let's go. It's Tamberg, or pretty solid team. I've a number of good players, and I think finished around the mid-table region in Bundesliga last season in real life. So they'll have a decent team on this. Need to be wary. Marcus Rashford is the main man up front. Ball on here. He found it. It's Jori. Cuts inside. Jori. Oh, I looked to go cut inside twice. I should have fed that little ball through there to Adelbert. He's so recognisable for his little ginger hit. Ginger hair Adelbert. That'll be his nickname for now. Gnado. Oz. What's this guy? Ozlek. I'm just going to call him Oz. Oz goes running down. Oh, he's kept it in. Shit. Well, out by Christensen. And on by Ricky. And Rash gives it to Adelbert. The ginger hair. He's running straight into danger. It's Young. Guaida. Just done us there. I can tell straight away, Hamburg aren't going to do the same walk over that Basel are. Or perhaps any of the others. The closest game we've had recently was against Bordeaux, where we won 2-1. Well, aside from the Mainz one, of course. This looks like the latter of one of them games against Hamburg. It's a lovely ball through there, though, as Jori goes clear. He doesn't have a huge amount of pace, but he's got enough to roast this man. And he's going to whip it in. Oh, it's a crucial tackle. It's Francis. It's a former player of ours, Steve Francis, is coming against us. So he knows Jori well. He read that well. Speaking of reading well, Lucas Hernandez read that well. He's giving it on to Christensen. To Ake. Make the run, George. There you go. And he's away. George. Runs off. Rash. Good play. It's Lucas Klostermar. Whip it in, Lucas. He has done. George. Oh, he's threatening. It's going to be George on the corner. Adelbert's there. Oh, I almost. Knew that was controlled by. Boy, nearly unleashed a shooting angle. It was Ricky. He's gone for it this time. Straight to Matinho, though. And we're creating more than them. Getting in threatening areas, but it will be a game where we have to fight for this against Hamburg. Looking reasonably well so far. It's lovely play by Timothy, though, who just bullies players off, and he's fed a lovely ball through to Adelbert. Adelbert cuts inside, goes for it. Oh, that's a strike it was. Good save by Matinho. So George again, the corner caused problems for Hamburg last time. Let's try it again. Not so much that time as to get rid, but on as far as Hernandez. Oh, Hernandez giving it away to Aaron Hunt. Shiplock. Feka. Oh, he's fucked it. Oh, he fucked it again, though. From midfield after that interception. Hunt. Just a heavy touch, the opposition. Well done, Lucas. Well played, son. Fosu. Jori. Now Marcus Rashford. Oh, unlucky Rash. Strong challenge. Otoku Sakai. Played by Sakai, though. He's got inside at the right time to Shiplock. Back to Sakai. Well done, Lucas Klostermar. Hernandez. George. Looks inside. Klostermar. Someone go wide, boys. Come on. Tielemans. It's a rash. Requiring a bit more build up against Hamburg, but we're edging up the pitch here. This is just way to play it against AI, generally, I find. Oh, nearly got in. Jori. He's just not quite quick enough there. It's Oz. To Kleber. Back to the keeper. In a while since there's been a chance, to be honest. We'll keep pressing them. And eventually we have made a mistake there. Of Ake getting it. Ricky. Oh, he looked to feed it inside. Sider got in the way. It wasn't Sai though. I don't know who that was, but someone got in the way. Right, time to whip this in. Get on that, boys. No one's there. Come on, lads. Well recovered by George. The pace he showed there is insane. And he'll have it back. And he'll whip it in. Oh, that's a no one. Hopefully Yuri can keep that in. He can't. Not quite clicking so far this game. Oh, as I said, Hamburg are much better. They've got an injury there, as you can see, against Reese. Oh, nice from Hamburg. Oh dear, shitbox in. Give it to Hunt. Great block, whoever that was. Nice. Nice from Panyaranda. Clear foul on him, but it's half-time anyway, so... a bit of a quiet half. Probably is deserved to be at 0-0. Fenerbahce are currently trailing, though, and Olympiacos are also trailing. Get in, Cologne and Berlin, the German sides. So, three German teams holding the top three right now. Hopefully, Hamburg are the ones to crack first, as they bring MES Barhitch on in place of Rees. Sparhitch, I had in my ultimate team, German side, for a while. He's not that quick, so if I get behind him with the likes of Rash or Adelbert, then he's in trouble. Saido's going to be dangerous off the bench, as well as Kelechi. Okay, nice play by you, Nathan. Make the run, Rash. There you go. Rash. Dangerous area. Oh, what's a tackle by us? I could have shot sooner, but I thought I got past him. I just thought, might as well carry on. It was a false assumption, as Oz goes through. It was the Guida Hunt. Nice from Hunt. Ship lock. It's back for Young. Oh, I nearly tackled him there. Son of a bitch. We'd have had a break on there. Hunt. Young. Terrible play by Young there, really. There's no way he's going to get to that. So George. Oh, great tackle that is. George's touch was shit, though. Really did let them get in. That's Sakai. Win that, Costa. Well done, lad. We'll go out again. See if George's touch is better this time. It is. He's taking it in his stride. Oh, come on, boys. Can't quite get past Hamburg so far. So I go ultra attacking actually. It's the first time I've done that today. See how that treats us. Shiplock. Should have tackled Bahiri. He's gone for the ball. I threatened to bring Costello out, then didn't. In the end, it was a wise decision. Tep. Adelbert. Oh, Adelbert. What are you doing, lad? Come on, need to settle down. I'm not playing anywhere near as well today. This game. And that clearance just sums it up, as Lucas goes to clear and comes straight off Christensen. We have been slightly blunt so far. It's going to be another corner there for Hamburg, who are dominating this half, really. So I think it's time for a sub. Penyanders tiring somewhat, so we'll bring Saido on. David didn't come on last game, so he can come on. I always take Yuri off. We have 2 weeks left, so I'll save him this time, actually, just to get him a better average rating. Take George off. And Kotabia can play a Cam actually instead of Ricky. So in that, on that fact actually, what I'll do is this. Put David there and swap Yuri. Play him back in the Cam position. He was dynamite from there last season. So corner for Hamburg. Could be dangerous this. It's well out by Christensen. Oh, Rashford. What a first touch that is. Marcus, go. He's gone wide to give the space for Saido. He's just come on. Oh, terrible first touch, Saido. But he's cut back inside. Saido, clear foul ref. Oh my God, I should have scored that one though. Saido's touch just took far too long. I feel like Marcus Rashford did everything right there. Tielemans, David. Again, Romano's about to play a ball through and he's been bundled into and no foul. The fuck out of it, ref. Shit, bad. Do you ever seem to give decisions that are frustrating happen when in games that you're not winning as well? No, at 5 or 6 nil up against Basel, I wouldn't be arsed if that happens. But it didn't happen. And it never does. Christensen. Tielemans. Good baller. It's Glostermar. Someone run. There we go, Rashford has in the end. Tell you what though, Lucas just kept going. Oh, he's tackled in the end by Pekka. This could be dangerous. Hunt. Well, I'm pretty sure we haven't had a 0-0 all season, but it does look destined for a 0-0 so far. Unless this changes things. Bahoui goes running through. Tell me about that's easily cost us though. He's going to look wide to Klosterman. Oh no, instead it's Fed. Go on, Fed. He's bustled off, finally, referee. Finally, you've done something. So, we're going to whip this one. Backstick with Lucas Glastonmar. That's well out by Francis. He's been pretty solid. Nandez. Okay. Side to Timothy. Katabia. Klosterman. Rush. Oh, looked inside. Now we have a lot of men. Udo overcommitted. A lot of space for Hamburg. The ball in for Kostic, who's rapid. I'm not going to catch him. What a challenge that is, though. Well done, Fed. Terrible work from Hamburg there, really. What are you doing? That's the only thing. I mean, we haven't. It's probably been the most boring game of the season, this, to be honest, because neither side really created much. So, it is the benefit. The good part. Hamburg. Haven't really looked like getting in behind us. Defensively, we're still looking pretty damn solid. Just not quite click attacking wise this episode. And there's another example. Young runs straight into play. The man. Well, that's a good play by Kostic. Who keeps going. I said he was quick. And it shows. Well done, Lucas. Late corner for Hamburg. Be heartbreaking if they score now. So let's get rid of this, boys. Well done. What a header that was by Yuri. Good challenge by Rash. Oh, Rash had got past the man there with his pace, breath. Let it go. Well, it does finish 0-0, and it probably was deserved, to be fair. As you can see, nothing really happened. Hamburg, you saw the bad side of the AI in this game, really. They did a lot of the ball, but they did fuck all with it. Great pass accuracy at 87%, but they had one shot and none on target. We had three of each. And, yeah, really, it was a game to forget. Sort of typical after a 7-0 that it works that way, but not much we could do. Fortunately for us, though, Fenerbahce did lose. English Football League One. And Olympiacos also lost, so Sassuolo drew. Galatasaray drew. Really was damage limitation there, actually. Probably worked out to be a good point for us. It was. We've actually extended our lead to 5 points. Mainz now in second. Lille 1. Mainz 2. Nice 1. That game was a complete showcase of how close the league is. 9 points separating the first from 11th, as a lot of teams that were mid-table beat the teams in the playoff positions. So yeah, considering we're playing a Hamburg side in 9th place, who've only lost 4 times in 15, it wasn't actually that bad a point. We were at home, sort of hoped to have won, but I'm happy with results elsewhere, I'll tell you that. In second, climbing the table are Mainz. So big gap points. Now in seventh, right till next game against Sassuolo, which looks big with them in fourth place. In eighth, CAFBB, Cruz has gone up in rating again, lovely stuff. Bustos is set to go up. Third bottom, Olympic Marseille, a couple of stats points. There as well. Fourth bottom, moving down are nice for Milo, 12th, who's getting closer to growing up in rating. So we're not on track financially. Reduce player wages. I'm not likely to reduce the wages, but if you remember what Bournemouth's wages are like at the start of the game, I'd end up with players on like £1,000 a week to potentially do that. There's no way I was ever going to be able to do that. So it was quite a harsh financial challenge, that one, I found. Thankfully, we're doing well elsewhere, so it sort of curtailed it going below like 70 or something. So as soon as we do get a financial challenge that's good, because last year's one was shit as well. You know, I'd like a financial one where it says improve the value of the club. That'd be ideal. Then on current form, if we were to be doing our financial one in terms of league, we'd be on about 90 managerial rating now, I think. So we have an update for these. Wow, Fabio Galliano's potential went way down. I did like the look of this guy because physically he's a boss for a 15-year-old. However, that change might well result in him getting cut. CDM, originally I was going to train him because I felt I was short in that position, of course, but Jay Robinson was beast there last time. Agustin Ortiz's potential is still really good, but his overall is pretty low, fortunately. Hoffman, always going down. I might let Hoffman go, to be honest. Or rather, because he's 16, I might call him up in January and try and loan him out then. May as well. Flavio Bustos, still beast potential wise. His potential was, I think, 82 to 94, so it's gone down somewhat, but he's still actually our second best keeper in the club. He's better than Cardenas and Duarte right now, unless they went up in this month. Cruz's potential, 83 to 93. Wow. Really does look like he's going to be good. A little Felipe Coutinho. Maldonado and Nunes. Right, I'm going to let Nunes go, actually. It's time to release him, I think. Same with Maldonado. The two Argentinians are on their way out. Same with Maya. I think it's time I got real and got tough. Get rid of some of these. Same with Edwards. And Prado. 17, he's only 56, so I'm just going to ignore the potential. Oh my god, this guy looks so good though. Julian Millot, 58, potential 85 to 94. He could be the best right back in the game one day. And look at his physicals. Millot, really do think highly of you. Ewan Roberts, to be fair, has grown a rating. Interesting. I've been saying, I'm pretty sure they've not been growing. I'm sure he's grown a rating there. I think it's time we promoted Ewan. You know, even if he's not... Holy shit. Look at some of his stats there. Wow. He is decent. 86 ball control already. He's only 16 or 17 or something. But yeah, he's... even though he's not going to probably play a game at all, the simple fact that he's in the squad when the months come around probably means his rating will go up. And as I said, that doesn't really seem to be happening with the youth squad. So maybe that's the key. Maybe I just have to promote them sooner, these boys. We've only got him on a year deal anyway, so if he does fail to grow and we can't loan him out, we can always just turf him out. So, you know, I could sign a few players on that basis. Patrick Harris. I should have realised this before, actually, and signed these guys before the new month, because that would have been straight away a bonus boost. But I might as well just get them in now while I still remember. Bustos is another one. Definitely going to promote now. So we'll have four keepers in the actual squad. Going to loan list all three of the sub ones, I think, and just see who comes in for who. I really don't mind. Crucial. I don't know why I even went over there. So the others can stay. I do need some players in the academy to keep it ticking along. But yes, as ever, at the start of the month, it's time for the squad report. So I'll just run through these relatively quickly. First and foremost, we'll look at the stats. So 9 clean sheets and 20 from Costell, nice. Klostermars 2. In fact, because you noticed the player growth, first and foremost, we'll look at these, actually. Klostermann's gone up in rating. 76. He was 75 last month. Get in, Lucas. He's still only 21 as well. Look at sprint speed. 97. It's unbelievable. He's probably the quickest player in the game right now in his career mode. Unless Alba's gone up. Christensen's still on 80, but constantly going to grow. Hernandez, still 78, constantly going to grow as well. And Ake, both fullbacks, 76. So I'll have traded first team defender right now, 76. That's why we've done so much better this year. Fosu, still the same. Oh, Yuri's grown a rating. Get in, Yuri. Now 81 rated, 21 mil he's worth already. And we actually signed him for 12 and a half, so he really was an excellent purchase, too, the month. Because 86 shot power, 85 long shots. I really do need to remember that and just bang it with him from distance. George has grown a rating. In fact, I think he already had, to be fair. Yeah, he already was 83. But for a free transfer, he's been brilliant. Stepanaro was already an 83 as well. Continuing to grow. Rush, already an 81. Kelechi's going right, gets in, gone to 80. So unless Saido or Adelbert are growing, he is actually our second highest rated striker right now. David's still at 76, but just look at some of the growth he's got. Really is brilliant. His passing in particular is excellent though. Has potential to be special, tag still. He's got himself 3 assists this season, lovely. Boris, constantly on the go. 68 now. I think he already was, to be fair, but he has an exciting prospect tag, which is 85 plus, I think. I think David's tag says that he'll get from 80 to 85, which I disagree with. I think he can get better than that, for sure. Peñaranda, still at 79. Got his first 2 goals and assist. Actually, he'd done nothing until that game against Basel. Everything came in that 30-minute spell, so... Lewis Cook's grown away. Get in. Yeah, 75 now. Well done, Lewis. Kotabia was already 79, I think. Ahan, same. Saido's grown. Get in. He's an 82. So, 3 strikers in the 80s now. You can see Saido's been dynamite since he's come in. We guys banged him in. He was our top scorer until Rash started going. Arthur's growing, but not fully grown, yeah. Cook's gone up again. Lovely. Duarte's starting to grow. He's another one, actually. Duarte's really sick in 2 stats and poor in others, so I could train him, get him good quickly, like Buster. Robinson started to grow, not surprised after his performance. Just 1 match he played a 7.6, kept a clean sheet, showing great potential as well. So we'll play Jay again pretty soon, I think. Dietrich was already a 65, I think. Billy Cook's growing right in, despite not featuring yet all season. They've both got an exciting prospect tag, these two actually, so. Yeah, I'll play Cook in the FA Cup. I'll tell you what, the FA Cup I might just offer up as like youth players, to be honest. Depends who I draw, I think. Martin's on the grow. He says his form's poor, he only played once, got 5.3, but I didn't give him full game, so I might have to start him soon. I'm just playing him one. Still only 16, don't forget. This guy's potential's pretty damn special. Cardenas has grown in rating, 63 now, again an exciting prospect tag. Van Drongen's grown, got his first game and kept his first clean sheet last time out. Pulisic hasn't played in quite a while actually. Again, I need to get him involved. Mings, is transfer listed? I don't really know why I did that. I don't want to sell Mings, to be honest. Fraser. Contract's expiring. We're going to let that one run out for Fraser. He's 74 rated, still only 23, so he's decent. In fact, he grew rating there, I think. But I don't know. I just don't really feel him. Gosling, same. We're going to let him go. Pew, too. Jordan Ibe's going in rating. I think he already had, to be fair, when I sent him to Middlesbrough. Cargill. Endman. Musa. Door growing. Lovely. George Roberts still yet to grow. Come on, Charlton, man. Roberts is looking like he may well get cut, actually. 18, he's 63, you know. Martin's 2 years younger, and he's already better. And we've got Milo on the grow as well. Richardson, similarly, isn't really growing. The loans just don't work out in this game, for me, on FIFA. It was a bit like that on last year's FIFA as well. It was just shit. So, it didn't actually show you the stats, but I'm not going to waste time. I don't want to take too long, so I'm literally just going to scroll through these quickly and just pause the video if you want to catch certain stats of certain players. Sapanara has been, oh, to be fair, 5 of his goals were in the International Cup. 6 assists, he's been much better now, give him credit for. Rashford's been the big man. 12 goals, 4 assists in 15 games in League 1. Oh my word, Rash, you beast. No wonder he grew a rating. No one else has come close to Rashford, really. It's Tielemans and Berahino and Sapanara You've been the next best, really. Dietrich, I forgot he got his assist. Pulisic got his goal like 4 minutes into his debut as well, by the way. So that's it. Lise Mousset's the only one that it's saying has actually played, but that's because he's in my league. He's actually plays for Bordeaux, so didn't notice him play against us. But I half wish he had, to be honest. Just to see him get involved. So Saido will continue to start, I've decided. They're both at 80, so I had to make a decision, but that's the way it's going to go. Cook has played a fair bit, so if it's time to drop him out and give Pulisic some game time. Jay Robinson, the same. Coming in for Ahan, who's probably made about 6 appearances this season. Robinson's only made 1, so we'll get Robinson involved there. Swap Becker out for Martin. And I won't forget about these boys, don't worry. They'll be drafted back in here and there. Well, time to skip now, ahead to the Sassuolo game, which is in about a week or so. So we'll have a couple more training sessions, might well get another scout report in. Not too sure. Oh, the contracts are accepted, of course, from the young lads. Excellent. So we have some more youth players there. Really, I'm looking forward to January, just to try and loan all these guys out. So all except Bustos, Robert and Harris. Wow, we've gone down to 68. What? That must be because of the new wages these guys are on. It's not a lot though, you know, it's 1200 extra quid off. And we've dropped 7 ratings, what the fuck? Dear me. As you can see, we have an international break there though, where we still miss big players, dear me. We miss Rash, Costil and Christensen, but it's better than it was last time, to be fair. We can play Tielemans. We can play Iheanacho and Berahino up top. Bustos, could give him his debut actually. Then just play Robinson at centre back maybe to fill in for them. And Harry Arter's not been playing this season anyway, so I don't care about that one. Yeah, I'll carry on with that. I think sooner we'll take Cruz off too and give one some extra to Milo. Although he has just grown a rating there of an excellent A. Ratings going all around. Bustos 64 already. Robinson 64 and Milo 59. It's excellent stuff. There is something I have to do quickly though, because this is usually the most damning indication of someone's potential is on here with stuff like this. Luis Hernandez and an exciting prospect, for instance. Not that I'd ever drop him out, but if ever I was going to, that's a game changer. So I'm going to search by position. Nah, that's what I mean. Bustos has potential to be special, it says. However, Cardenas is an exciting prospect. Despite being 1 rating less and a year older, the game seems to think he'll be better. So maybe we should be better training Cardenas more. He does look more balanced, to be fair. Exciting prospect. Where are the other boys? So, Tony Robinson's showing great potential. I already had him in, to be fair. Who are the other lads I promoted then? I'm trying to remember, not. Shit, where the hell were they? So... I recognise all these names. Cook. Patrick Harris was one of them. Wow, he's got an exciting prospect tag. I've got so many CMs who have exciting prospect tag. Cook and Harris. No, maybe not, it's just them two. Fair enough. Evercam there. Dietrich on exciting prospect though. As well as Rashford and Kelechi, so... That will probably end up being my main first 11, you know, later on down a series. It depends, of course. Some players grow, some others don't. Some I'll be training continually and others I won't. But I'm glad I've checked that. once I have promoted him, because I'll take Bustos off and get Cardenas back on the training. He was the first one I promoted through, so he's still probably my favourite one. We have a Scott player out, Leandro Navarrete. Don't really care about that. Fair enough then. Rick said he wants the game, so instead of playing Robinson, we'll keep Robinson on the bench. Maybe bring him on for Fosu when he tires. And instead of Christensen, we'll play Rick. Leandro Angelin. So, I am going to be training Cardenas, but he and Duarte have both played before the season, so we'll go for Bustos' debut. And of course, he's the best rated one anyway. And it's time to take Rash out for Kelechi. Only got the one striker on the bench, so that's why it's concerning that my strikers are being picked internationally. I'm half convinced there might be one week where all four go. Tell you what, let's give Roberts a game. I've just called this guy up, I think. Cook on the bench as well for Khatib. Romano's played plenty of games. Just rotating a bit. Getting all these games, at least one game time, will help the development. So, we're not in a hugely comfortable position at the top of the table in terms of points. But 5 points is still decent. And I think I might as well sort of do that now. Get these guys involved a bit more for substitute periods. So we'll see. If I'm losing 60 minutes in, there's no way I will. So we have Sassuolo at home, last game of the episode. I have a week until Torino away, so I can just sort of leave the subs relatively late then, to be fair. Well, we're playing on the 11th. Interesting. We play Torino on my birthday then, a week from this. So that'll be first game of next episode. I really hope we put a performance in for the manager then on his birthday. So Sassuolo, we've actually met once before. Last year when I was in League 2, I played them in the... what is it called? I keep forgetting. The Checker Trade Trophy, that's it. It's that tournament that Panathinaikos knocked me out on Sim this year, which is a tournament for teams in the 3rd and 4th division in England. And we played Sassuolo with a weakened team and beat them 2-0. Tequila Ranti, I remember, in that game in particular, was an absolute beast. So, really looking ahead with my first team, I think we should beat Sassuolo, despite the fact of we've had a really solid start to the season themselves. I do consider us favourites, so decent-ish start though. Bustos has got it out. So Bustos is actually black. I say that because... Danger! Oh my god, Bustos. I thought I'd just gone straight through him first, but good save up. Yeah, I say that because Boris, Sven Becker's, what a clue that is, by the way. Sven Becker's avatar is black, but his player on the pitch is white, so really weird that. Bustos is the same. Challenge there, George. It's another foot in. Press him, George. Well done, Ake. Now give it back to George. He's got the pace. His first touch is decent. Can he get clear? He has done. George, on and on he goes. He looks to feed back. It's a Berahino. George, following up. Ah, straight to Consigli. Winner. He should have won that. And Smazzatelli comes out with it. Matri. Still love Alessandro Matri. Well done, Yori. Win the header. Nice play, Yori. Well done, lad. Known by George. Ricky. Oh, the space here. For Kelechi to run into. He looks back for Yori. Yori still. Oh, dear me. Player was just standing there waiting for that ball inside those. Not really much he could do to get it to Tielemans, I suppose. So it was decent defending by them to make sure that was the case. Yori. Nice. Back to Yori this time. Again, the crucial tackle. Fuck you, Sassuolo. Decent football, though. We keep tackling them high up the pitch and getting in these situations. Already a couple of times. Or three. We've had chances like that. Great challenge as well by Lucas Hernandez as we limit Sas and their attacking threat. Now Inter could get through again. It's good, lovely give and go with him and Ake. George, here he goes. Oh, it's looked too central there though. Francesco Acerbi to cut across very nicely.
This is the kind of pitch that I think attacking players favour, Alan, don't they?
I think they do, yeah. Because
no one really made a run, so we'll have to just give it to Ake. Disappointed with the players there though, not offering space. Klostermar, Glecci, Fosu, big tackle.
And that will be handball.
Handball? Get the fuck off, referee, shit up. Not having that. So Gazzola. Well out there by George. Been our best player so far, looking almost dangerous, certainly. Getting on the ball a lot, and there he goes, with his dribbling. Yeah, it's been challenged, but Saido's picked it up. And DMA George has stayed down. This could be bad. He's still down. Yuri. Oh, play it quick, Yuri. Serious numbers advantage for Sas on the break. And they could be in here. Do it for. Oh, bust off, you beast. Well done.
Goalkeeper made the save, but he couldn't hold it.
Timothy. What the fuck was that? To be fair, Ntep's injured. I think that's why he sort of stopped running for it.
Probing away, trying to find room for a shot, maybe. To put them in front.
Terrible shot there from Gazzola. So, both sides have looked mildly threatening at times in this match. Sassuolo certainly do have a capability to score against us. Which not many sides have done, of course, this season so far.
Into the attacking third.
We are still looking better though. Oh, it's nearly wormed your way through there, Yuri. Lucky lad.
Gazzola.
Lucky from Ake. Win now. Well done, George. Great ball by Vendrongen, no? Ake takes in a stride. Ake, lovely ball. It wasn't meant for Saido, but he'd pick it up. Oh, what a tackle that is. Just something about to unleash with Saido. That is three or four times they've made crucial tackles. Sassuolo, a classic Italian team, these. Klostermar, Iheanacho. Oh, the back heel. Almost win it. For fuck's sake, boys. Just not quite getting to these 50-50s. That's the difference right now, because we're making the chances. Or the half chances. Big tackle by Fosu. Kelechi has played it through. Ricky, bang it for me. Oh, it's a goal, Ricky. Get in. That was a sick finish by Saponara. He goes straight to camera. Saponara's come alive in this episode. And I think that's his 7th goal of the season, perhaps. Pretty good going for the lad. 5 of them came in the sim. I mean, he was dynamite in his sim, like to a ridiculous extent. But I'm finally starting to see it myself now. Le Marchand. So it was big time to get that goal. I was getting a bit frustrated because it would have been 3 halves of football if I was scoring after getting 7 against Basel. And we'd had a few half chances, but that was big. Oh no, Sas could be in now though. Pretty comfortable save for Bustos. So lovely stuff. I think the assist was by Iheanacho as we head to the break. Fenerbahce lead, Mainz also lead. So the two teams behind us are winning. I keep forgetting who else is up there, to be honest. Hamburg around there, I think. They're winning. West Brom are winning. Olympiacos drawing. So, yeah, the top three are winning. I think we're all going to sort of pull clear a bit. And of course, Sassuolo are up there. They, of course, trail right now. Big tackle there. Klostermann, but we still got it. Okay. Nice play by Ake to work the space. That was a terrible pass, though. Well done, George. He shrugged off his injury. That's a brilliant tackle.
Gazzola.
Oh, nearly. George again. We played Ake. Winzar. Van Drongelen. Good play, boys. Just keep patient. Saponara eventually gives it to Timothy. Oh, I looked inside. The ball was almost on. It's Duncan. Sensi. Read the ball. Still couldn't stop it though. Matri played a nice pass through. He scored it back. Matri. Big block by Van Drongelen. Klossmann's kept it in, but only as far as Missaroli. Gives it back to Duncan. Duncan. Shake the Bustos. Made one good save in particular, Bustos. Nothing particularly out there, but the fact he's getting a lot of saves will give him a decent rating, which I'm really happy to see. Nice calm work from you there, Rick. Been impressed with him so far this game. Not only his, something like his third appearance. Winner. Well done, Klosterman. Not too far out, though. It's Sensi. It's better than the last 10 minutes for Sassuolo. I haven't really seen much of the ball the second half, to be honest. Well done, though, Tim. Okay. Berahino. George. Use your pace, George. Go on. Just go for it. He's doing it, George. Oh, lucky. Beat two of them. Comfortable, lah. Sassuolo. Really run out of ideas at times. Timothy picks it up. It's the Tielemans. Yuri, how's the ball on there? He's found him. George is going to keep that in a thing. Oh, no. Even George isn't quick enough. I'm not too bothered that went out, though, actually, because it's time to get some of our youth players on off the bench. So I actually have four of them on. I have a decision to make. We have Martin again. He had a really poor rating last time. Not got a lot of time to do much here, but hopefully he can manage something. He can only play it right back, so I'll just swap Klostermar over. Dietrich has had three appearances, so he'll be the one to miss out. It's going to be Cook. Billy Cook for Fosu. And I'm sorry, Pulisic. He's only played five times, but it's going to have to be Roberts. Pulisic's time will come, maybe in the FA Cup. But it's still a bit precarious. We're only 1-0 up, and we do have a number of players in the 60s on. Yeah. But I have faith that they can help us see it out. As Cook gives it to Tielemans. Well, in the end, it's one of our mainstays who's giving it away. Yuri. Lari, Politano, Gazzoli. Oh, lucky Klosterman. Nearly a big, big challenge there. Matri. Been a danger man so far this game. Oh, unlucky, whoever that was. It might have been Klosterman. Danger here, boys. Get red, get red. Just hoof it. Nice hoof, Hernandez. Win now. Come inside, though. Shit out of that, mate. Oh, no, danger. Oh, it's 1-0. Fuck. That's not what I wanted, because straight away that's happened. I've got a much weaker team now. You know, if you're going to score Sass, do it 10 minutes ago, so I can put real players on. Ah, God, it is Matri. We did say it was a danger man. It's going to be ultra attack. And I've got to be honest, I'll be disappointed if we draw two in a row, having just beaten someone 7-0. Iheanacho, trying to follow it up though. Can't quite, as Consili gets it straight away. But yeah, two draws in a row will be a bit of a end to our decent run. There's still time, boys. It's Cook. Great ball. Iheanacho. That's the pace. Kelechi. Fires it across. Oh, it's an own goal. Get in. Come on, boys. It's off Lamarche and in the end. But one of the subs started the move. Cook. Who gave it to Kelechi. He was looking far post for Roberts, I think. Or maybe Saido. And in the end, it's a swift return to the lead for us. Get in. So time to go back to attacking. In fact, no, we'll go defence, ultra defensive now. I usually struggle to keep hold of the ball for long if I'm on ultra defensive, but of course it's worth doing it now. Match out, a great ball through. Yuri. He's found a nice ball to Kelechi. Now Saido. First touch, not great. He'll cut inside. Still got it, Saido. Back heel to Kelechi. Oh, he went for the strike to finish it. And it's a crucial block. Well done, Ricky. He's done well there. Saido. Gives it away. Great ball, that. To LaMarchand. Looks to atone. I thought Van Jongelen handball that, to be honest. But we got away with it. Jori. To Kelechi. What's the first touch that is from Kelechi? Oh, Serbia recovered well, though. With the help of Pellegrini. He sort of just sandwiched them out a bit. Oh, danger here, boys. Mitrovic. Oh, well, first. Oh, it's just brilliant from Sassuolo. Nothing I could do about that. The 1-2s were fucking sensation. Fuck's sake. Twice we've led, twice we've conceded, and again. For the second home game in a row, it looks like we're going to concede a last minute equaliser. Unless we pull something out the bag here. I know, we're giving it away by Jori. Come on, Jori, you've been shit today. Win it. Twice have tackled and we come away with it. Fuck's sake. I'm disappointed with that, to be honest. Sassuolo, like Hamburg, were in the top half, so they were decent teams we faced. But, well, to their credit, they probably did. They easily deserved it, actually, looking at that. They did have 10 shots or 4, 8 on targets or 3, so I'm disappointed in the respect that we conceded in the 89th minute and we let 2 leads slip. But they did deserve it. However, we were missing some players, of course, so this team here will be the weakest you see for quite a while. I'm hoping anyway. We'll see. I think I've got a week gap, actually, so they should be back for the Torino match. Mainz won, Fenerbahce also won. They cut the lead to 3 points. Bad couple of weeks for us there. And in the end, this episode was actually yielded less points than last episode. However, we are still in a good situation there. The problem, as you can see, is we've drawn 6 games. We still only lost 1, which is promising. Still only conceded 9 as well, so we haven't conceded more than 1 all season. Oh no, that was it. Shit, I've just disregarded the score. We just conceded 2 to Sass. So that was the first time. But the fixtures will come easier, because as you can see, if I run through this now, look at the top half, we have at the top of the table, 7 games left until the halfway mark. We've played Mainz, we've played Fenerbahce, we've played Olympiacos, we've played West Brom, we've played Sass. We had to play Gala, but we've played Hamburg, we've played Cologne. We haven't played Hoffenheim, we've played... we haven't played St Etienne, but we've played Hoffenheim in Swansea. So 5 of the 7 teams we have yet to play are in the bottom half. So that bodes well, boys. Starting with Torino, we're actually top of the bottom half at 13. So that'll be next episode. We'll at least skip to it now, though. Because we do have a 2 monthly scouting reports to come back. It'll be the last from France and another one from Holland. Cardenas, as I said, will get back on the training. So I'll get him on this hard one-on-one goalkeeping. When Cruz goes to 62, I'll take him off and give Milo another. So not just yet, but I'm happy to continue training all the other boys. Again, that's shit. Maybe I should start playing one an episode again. It's FDDCC. CD, sorry. So not great that. Thanks from Ricky. No worries, Rick. It'll be the last time he plays for a while, to be fair. But whenever they do ask me, I usually do give them a game. Unless they are like really random and like completely out of my thoughts. He's got a player, Aurelien Richard, clearly a Frenchman. So we'll see what he's like in a day, I think. Yeah, there we go. That was a good shot. Mid-month and it was around there. One for the future just popped up as Tyler Cook, actually. First time I've seen one of our players on there. We're back to a 75 for some reason. I really don't understand why. You know, our league form's actually got worse the last couple of games. We have a 16-year-old here, by the way. He's 51 to 63, Hurtado. I did want more of an update on him, and yet another keeper. But I think it is time we brought him in. Leandro Navarrete was poached. I don't really mind. Mancia. overall is not ideal, but his potential is high, and he plays in a position. I was going to say that we need. No, we don't really. I think he's a cam, but I'll bring him in anyway. Why the hell not? This guy can go for sure. As can this guy. And this guy. Save again. Nothing really else from here. I'll just skip through these. Oh, this guy though. Overall, 49 to 67, potentially. There's a big gap there, but I'm willing to see what he's about. So come on, I've had a lot of these potentials that have been high 60s, and they all came in as like 55, 56, or something like that. I just want one guy to come in as like a 66, because I'd train the shit out of him and get him to a 90 within about four seasons. Back to Holland. I think that said it was the final time in France, actually. Did I skip that? I'll double check me scout availability after this. Van den Bosch. Back, I'm going to let these guys go. He's got good potential, this guy, though. Same with this fella. Same with all of them, really. Potentially, well, it's all decent, except Jacob, so he can go. Too many keepers as is. This guy, Danny Mulder, looks decent. Could be a striker as well. I just haven't got enough striker. Decent player options so far. So, maybe need one of them. Hoekstra is another one who could potentially be really like mid-60s. I'll leave Hoekstra. I'll definitely send that Mulder up though and say no to this guy. So, oh, we do have more. No, then that's it for Holland. So, happy to let these carry on. Get rid of this guy. Ignore his potential for his overalls that bad. He's 17. He's not going to get to that point, I don't think. So just before the episode is done, realise it was a long episode, but it always is when it's a squad report one, to be fair. So yes, we have a centre forward who's a young product, Danny Mulder. Let's just see what his rating is. Mancio we brought in is a 50 rated cam. Not great, to be honest. Hitardo arrived as a 57 rated keeper, so again he's just going to sit down. We'll just see if he goes up or something. Mulder's 60 rated, 17. There is potential to work with him because he's reasonably quick. As you can see, his curve 79 as well. I always quite like curving it with the finesse. Avia, 57. Still, Milo really stands out amongst all of them so far. Yeah, I've sort of already promoted all the good ones. Miguel Cruz obviously stands out as well, to be fair. So I think I have time for Danny Mulder to potentially train him. With just four strikers this season, if he does end up getting promoted, he will get game time. Like a reasonable amount, at least five games in a season, I'd say. So we'll see. We'll see what he's about next training session. That is it for this episode though, guys, so thanks for joining me. Next episode we will be taking on, as it's currently my birthday, I would be 25 on that day, it's Torino. Hopefully we return to winning ways for my birthday, as we've drawn two games now in a row, I think 0-0 and 2-2. Bit disappointing though, but the first game particularly this episode was the best we've played in the whole series, so if we return to that form, we'll do well. And as I did say, actually, we do better away from home. We were away to Basel 1-7-0 and drew two games at home. So we go back to we go to Italy, to Turin, see how we get on. Then we have Lille at home. Then Galatasaray away. So they're the two. That's one of the teams, two teams left in the top half we haven't played yet, Gala. So Saint Etienne are the next one as well. So they'll be difficult then too, but so hopefully we come good. Oh, I'm glad I clicked across, by the way, because as you can see, we actually played Nice three times in a month, weirdly, because we have them in the second round of the FA Cup away. So against Nice, I think I could potentially play a few a slightly weakened team, a few fringe men. Maybe half the first team, half the fringe, with some powerful players on the bench just in case. So that might be the case. But that's looking ahead to episodes down the line, of course. But I'm glad I realised the FA Cup draw had been done, just to check out what we got.